The next page is the columns page. The columns page contains the same information that was already present in the tables page. The only difference is in the way data is organized. All the columns are presented together in a single pivot table, so there is no longer a division by table. This is useful because you can sort the columns by size. We have already done it, but we can do that again. You can go on the column total size, right-click, and sort it from the largest to the smallest. And this is telling me that the sales order number column that is in a table with 12 million rows is using 80 megabytes out of a total of 170 megabytes of the model. So 45% of the total database size is used by only one column, that is the order number. Typically, in a typical database, the first 5-10 columns are responsible for the vast majority of the size of the database. This might be normal or not, depending on the nature of your database, but it gives you the capability of focusing on the most problematic columns, the largest one, the ones that are probably slower to scan. So if you need to work and reduce the size of a column, you know that reducing the column which are top in this list is probably the most important thing to do. The remaining part of the column is nothing new. They are only the column that we have already seen in the tables page, just organized by column instead of being organized by table.